dress van. Make you small.
Welcome to Dining with the DJ. Tonight we've got Lillie Morales, a Jersey fashionista, fashion blogger, entrepreneur, and 93 Entertainment client. So please join us and let's discuss fashion style. You're behind Jersey Fashionista.
Yeah.
So to me that says there's something very unique and special about Jersey fashion and just Jersey in general.
You know, I've always been a Jersey girl, born and raised, but I felt like I had this more of a connection to fashion than what was around me. Mm-hmm. So around me is like, you know, I grew up in like suburbia kind of area, so it was like if I wore like a pair of pleather pants and, you know, like a studded jacket, it was like, well, is she going to New York or something? So I feel like Jersey Fashionista is like the Jersey girl that has a connection to the outside world, like to fashion, okay. Which is not really fashion in Jersey, it's more like you just get it.
Right.
So that's where that comes
from. The internal aspect of every girl that lives in Jersey is also connected to worldwide fashion.
Yeah.
Excellent. Exactly. So you took the attention, you took it from Lillie's world.
Yeah.
You took the attention away from yourself and made it more on your audience that's really your readers, essentially.
Yeah, I wanted to be able to relate to a lot of people, and even I have readers that aren't from New Jersey, so right. Which is really nice. I get a couple of people like from the UK and everything,
oh,
like
wow.
Writing. So, I mean, I think it's not just Jersey, it's, you know, right. It's more than
so
that.
So Jersey Fashionista is really international?
Yeah, pretty much.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So what is it that, you know, you came from suburban New Jersey, what is it that inspires you from a fashion perspective? Where are you getting your inspiration and ideas from?
Oh, well, I mean, that goes back. I mean, as a child, like I, you know, growing up, I guess I could credit my aunt a little bit. My aunts were older than me and they would have like Vogue magazines and I would just like, you know, probably like her age, I would just start flipping through Vogue and I did beauty pageants and everything, but you know, just kind of like being able to see those magazines, and it just, this whole world like came out
right.
Within me, you know, so.
Right.
It's
which was different from
like
what you were seeing like in school and around you in suburban New Jersey.
I mean, at home, like I was very attached to my father's sister and my grandmother. My father's sister used to look in the magazines and my grandmother used to sew. So
oh, wow.
She would look in the magazine and say, oh, Mom, I love this. And my grandmother would sew it for her.
Wow.
So she was always into fashion and she went to cosmetology school and then my mother was in beauty school, so I was kind of like their dummy. So like they would do all the hairstyles on me and I was just like, wow, like this is so great, you know,
yeah,
like
that's
I
pretty
see
cool
like
for
the blue eyeshadow and in the 80s, so you know, like all those things like Madonna's like really was one of my big inspirations.
It was a big inspiration,
yeah.
Yeah.
So just anything like that, even Boy George with the hats, you know, like I'm dating myself, but
that's okay. That was some of the best music we've
yeah,
ever had.
It was, yeah.
Right. So then I guess you see stuff like Madonna, right? That's very, I guess now they would call it do-it-yourself. You kind of just grab whatever you have around you and
yeah.
You kind of make it your own, make it your style. And the fact that you had that just going on in your house, you know, so you had grandma sewing and you had your mom and your aunt just piecing things together because of their schooling.
Yeah.
You were just inundated with it. It's
definitely.
Just kind of, it's part of your everyday life at that point.
Definitely.
Very cool. So yeah, there's definitely a lot of influences to turn to.
Oh yeah.
Right. So then you took that, you weren't dressing just like Madonna, you were taking elements of what she did, or someone else in the 80s, you were going, okay, I like their style, and I'm gonna turn it into my own.
Yeah, it all comes from something, and even growing up, like I would have arguments with my mother about like, I don't want to wear what you want, and you know, like.
I think we've all had that argument.
Yeah, it was just like, oh my gosh, like I always had my own way of doing things, so,
right.
You know, and she's pretty much.
Which is, I was going to say that, let's bring that
yeah,
up, that's
but I don't have that problem, like she thinks I'm her stylist every day, so she'll say, Mommy, can you
Are you not?
Pick out,
she
like,
told me you were her stylist.
Yeah. She likes to like shop, but then she's like, can you put it together for me? And I'm like,
right.
Okay, like.
Yeah,
you know, so,
that's good. You need
yeah.
to know a little bit of an expert to help guide you a little bit.
Yeah, she likes to look well
together.
Presented. So,
yeah.
Yeah,
well, that's good. I think that's commendable when you're at that age because you don't necessarily value that until you get
yeah.
to a certain point in your life, but it's good to get there earlier.
Definitely. I mean, I'm happy that she came out like that.